everyone, welcome back to our class. This is our 7th lesson and we're still studying about type 4 reading part of topic test. How was your study going? Hopefully it's not that difficult. And then I'm very helpful for you to take, you know, good score at your test. Okay. So we're still studying about type 4 question number from 43 to 45, and we need to read a short story and find out which is correct about this story. Okay, so important thing is then you need to find, you know, time, vocabulary, frequency, vocabulary, and who are in the story, I or my family or my friend, and you need to find out the right subject, okay? Alright, here we go. Ready for number 8. Alright, here we go. 저는 요리를 못합니다. 그래서 매일 군의 식당에서 밥을 먹습니다. 군의 식당은 음식값이 싸고 밥이 맛있습니다. Can you find out which is the main, you know, subject? I mean main person. It's 저. This is the story about me, alright? And is there any vocabulary you don't understand? Maybe do you know about 군의 식당? 군의 식당 mean the restaurant in the inside of the company. Inside of my work or school, you know, if I'm student, the restaurant is about in the school restaurant. And then if I'm working, the restaurant inside of the company building, that is 군의 식당. Okay. All right, here we go. 저는 요리를 못합니다. 못 mean not, right? Can't. I can't do. 요리. 요리 is cooking, right? So I can't cook mean I'm very, very bad at cooking, right? Bad at cooking. Do you? Are you? Are you bad at cooking? I'm a little bit, you know, I think I'm good cook. I'm good chef, alright? But the Korean food or Italian food. Okay. And then 그래서 means so, right? So I 나는 요리를 못합니다. So 그래서 매일. Here's the frequency vocabulary 매일. What is 매일? Every day, right? Every day. 군의 식당에서 식당 means restaurant, right? Restaurant에서 밥을 먹습니다. I eat
every day at the, you know, the school restaurant. 군의 식당은 군의 식당에 대한 this is about, you know, the restaurant of school restaurant. 음식값이 싸고 싸고, 싸다 mean cheap. What is cheap? 음식값. The price of the food, right? Food is cheap. And 밥이 맛있습니다. It's very delicious, right? So very good. The 군의 식당, the restaurant of school restaurant, the food of the restaurant is very good, right? Cheap and delicious. Let's find which is correct. Number one, 저는 군의 식당에 날마다 갑니다. 날마다, 마다가 나왔어요. 마다, what does it mean, 마다? Every, right? Every day. 날마다. So don't forget, 날마다. And 매일 is equal. It's same. 날마다 and 매일. Okay. Number two. Oh, so it's correct, right? 매일. Number two, 군의 식당에 밥이 없습니다.
없습니다 mean there's nothing. 군의 식당에 밥이 없습니까?
아니요. 매일 군의 식당에서 밥을 먹습니다. 밥이 있습니다.
There are some food, right, at the restaurant.
B. Number three. 군의 식당은 조금 비쌉니다. 비쌉니다. 비싸다 mean expensive.
So the food of the restaurant is expensive.
B. 음식 값이 싸고 mean the food is very cheap, right? B. Number four. 저는 맛있는 음식을 잘 만듭니다. 잘 만듭니다. 음식을 잘 만들다. 음식을 만들다 mean 요리를 하다.
Cook.
But I said, 아, 나 저는 요리를 못합니다. So it's not correct. The right answer will be number one. Number nine. Let's read in the box.
어제 동생과 눈썰 매장에 처음 갔습니다. 그곳에는 눈썰매를 타는 사람들이 많았습니다. 우리도 즐겁게 눈썰매를 탔습니다.
So here, what is main person subject here? 어제, it's about the, of course, it's about me and my brother or sister.
In Korean, 동생 is younger one. Of my, you know, family members.
So, 우리,
we, my little one, and I.
So, let's find out. There's time vocabulary. 어제.
When is 어제?
Yesterday. Yesterday, 동생과 눈썰매장에 갔습니다.
So A, normally we can put that for the places and time, right? So here, 눈썰매장, 눈썰매장. You know what 썰매장 is? You can taking the sled, okay, sledding.
So in Korea, there are some place, you know, 눈썰매장, sledding place.
So you can borrow the sled and going up the high, like a ski resort. So you can go up high and going down with sled.
I don't like it because it's a little bit scary. Okay, 어제 동생과 눈썰매장에 처음 갔습니다.
처음 mean it's my first time, okay?
So I never been before at the sledding place before. It's my first time. 그곳에는
where is 그곳?
Is 눈썰매를 타는 사람들이 많았습니다. Of course, 눈썰매장, the sledding resort, there's a lot of people are sledding, right?
우리
동생 and 나 우리도 즐겁게 눈썰매를 탔습니다. 즐겁게 happily we take 눈썰매 sledding. Alright? So let's find out which is correct. Number one, 저는 눈썰매장에서 동생을 만났습니다. 동생을 만났습니다.
I meet my brother at the, you know, sledding resort. Is it true?
No, we went there together. B. 저는 눈썰매장에 혼자 갔습니다. Did I go alone? No, I go with my little brother. 동생과 함께. Right? B. Number three, 저는 어제 눈썰매를 탔습니다. 어제
is about yesterday.
눈썰매를 탔습니다. I sled. Is it true?
Yeah.
우리도 어제 눈썰매장에 가서 눈썰매를 즐겁게 눈썰매를 탔습니다. It's correct. Number four, 저는 자주 눈썰매 장에 갑니다. 자주 mean often, many times, often. But it's not true because I said 처음. It's my first time to go there, right? So 자주, no 자주, no often, right? It's first time in my life, alright? So right answer is number three. Number 10. Let's read the story in the box.
저는 어제 영화를 봤습니다. 그 영화가 재미있어서 아버지께 표 두 장을 사드렸습니다. 아버지는 내일 할머니와 영화를 보러 가실 겁니다.
Alright, do you understand the story? There's so many people are there, right? First, 저, 나, I, and who were in the story? 아버지, right? And the 할머니, right? So, it's my subject will be, oh my god, I'm standing in the middle of the screen. It's so main subject about 영화, movie, okay? Okay.
저는 어제, time, vocabulary, yesterday, 영화를 봤습니다.
It's finished already. I did. What did I do? I saw the movie yesterday, okay? And 그 영화가, 그 영화, the movie I saw, 재미있어서, this will be the reason, 땡땡어서, is the movie I saw was so fun, so, 그래서, 아버지께, to my father, 표 두 장을 사드렸습니다. I did to my father, by For my father, what did I do? I bought 표 두 장, two tickets. 표 두 장, two tickets. Okay, two tickets. 아버지는, my father, 내일 is time frequency, time vocabulary. 내일, when is it 내일? Tomorrow, right? Tomorrow. 할머니와 영화를 보러 가실 겁니다. It happened yet. 가실 겁니다. He will
go to see the movie with whom? 할머니와.
When?
Tomorrow.
Okay? So number one, 저는 아버지와 영화를 봤습니다. I saw the movie. That's true. But I saw the movie with my father. No. I saw the movie We don't know whom. Alone or with a friend, we don't know. But my father haven't seen the movie yet, right? Because I bought a ticket for him and he will go to watch movie tomorrow. He didn't watch yet, right? And number, so this is not true. Number two,
아버지는 저에게 영화표를 사주었습니다.
Who bought the ticket, movie ticket? I, right? I bought a movie ticket for my father. Not my father bought the ticket for me, right? B. Number three.
할머니는 내일 영화를 보러 가실 겁니다.
My granny, 영화를 보실 겁니다. Will watch the movie when? 내일. Is it true? Yes, because 내일 아버지는 할머니와 영화를 보러 가시니까 my grandma, 할머니는 영화를 보실 겁니다. That's true. Number four,
아버지는 영화표를 사셨습니다.
That's not true. Who bought the ticket? Me. I bought a ticket. I bought two tickets, right? I bought two tickets for my father and grandmother. Not my father bought the ticket, okay? Our right answer will be number three. Number 11.
저는 한국 사람이지만 프랑스에서 살고 있습니다. 그래서 한국어와 불어를 모두 잘합니다. 지금은 중국어를 배우고 있습니다.
Do I read so fast?
All right, I'm going to read a little bit slowly after this question. 저는,
this is about me, right? 저는
한국 사람이지만 something will be changed, right? 한국 사람, I am Korean,
but
프랑스에서 살고 있습니다. 살고 있습니다 mean lives, right? Live.
Where do I live? 프랑스에서.
프랑스에서 살고 있어요.
French. France, right? I live at France. 그래서 so
한국어와 불어를 모두 잘합니다.
한국어와 불어.
한국어, Korean,
불어, French.
Why? How? How come? How come?
I can speak Korean and French because I am Korean, but and I live in France, so I can speak French and Korean.
지금은
now
중국어를 배우고 있습니다.
중국어
Chinese.
In Korea, 땡땡 어미 language, okay?
Language.
그래서 중국어, 중국,
China,
a language,
China, language, me,
중국어,
Chinese, okay?
I'm learning
Chinese now.
Number one, 저는 불어를 배우고 싶습니다. 땡땡고 싶습니다.
땡땡고 싶다 mean I want to do something.
Do I want to learn the French?
No, I already can speak French, right? Because I live in France, right?
Number two, 저는 지금 한국에 있습니다.
It's not true.
Because 프랑스에서 살고 있습니다.
Where am I?
I am at France, not Korea, right? Number three, 저는 한국어를 잘 못합니다.
Is it true?
저는 한국 사람입니다. 한국어와 불어 모두 잘합니다.
모두 mean both, all, right? I can speak Korean and French both, right?
Number four, 저는 중국어를 공부합니다.
공부합니다 means study.
Study Chinese. Is it true? 중국어를 배우고 있습니다.
Learn Chinese.
Learn mean I study, right? Study and learn a little bit similar, right? So it's same meaning, right? So right answer will be number four.
Number 12, 다음의 내용과 같은 것을 고르십시오. 저는 친구와 비행기로 집에 갔습니다.
Oops, sorry.
거기에서 배를 타고 아름다운 바다를 봤습니다. 내년에는 가족과 괌에 가고 싶습니다.
This story is about
저, I.
So in Korean, I or 나, 저, right? 제, 어, very polite word. 저는
okay.
저는 친구와 비행기로 괌에 갔습니다.
This is a place. The island. Guam.
Island Guam. I went to Guam with whom? 친구와 by airplane, right?
Of course. What else can you take to go Guam?
That is island. Maybe ship, right? And then 거기에서 땡땡에서 거기 mean Guam, right? There.
배를 타고 아름다운 바다를 봤습니다.
What did I do? 배를 타고
배, the ship, boat, cruise, ferry, right?
아름다운 바다를 봤습니다.
I saw.
I saw what?
아름다운 바다.
beautiful sea.
아름다운 바다를 봤습니다.
내년에는 is keyword 내년. 내년 mean 다음 해, 다음 년.
Next year mean next year.
I didn't mention before about the time, frequency, time, the vocabulary. So about year. The other things always say, you can say this day, this morning, next morning, last morning. But year for last year,
지난해, 작년 or 작년.
Okay, 작년, last year, and then this year,
올해,
next year,
내년,
or 다음 해,
okay?
작년, 올해, 내년. So 내년 means next year. 내년에는 가족과 괌에 가고 싶습니다. 고 싶다 means I want to do. I want to go to Guam with my family. Okay? 가족과. 같은 내용을 골라보세요. Number one. 저는 가족과 함께 비행기를 탔습니다. And this three. Who come with me? Who comes with me?
친구와, not family. 친구와 괌에 갔습니다.
Number two, 저는 내년에 친구와 괌에 가려고 합니다. 내년 mean next year. 내년에는 가족과 괌에 가려고 해요. 친구는 아니에요. Number three, 저는 괌에서 바다를 구경했습니다. 괌에서 바다를 구경했습니다.
구경 means see.
And the other word in Korean, 보다. 봤습니다. 아름다운 바다를 봤습니다. That's correct. Number four, 저는 배를 타고 괌에 갔습니다.
Did I take the ship to go to the Guam?
No, airplane. 비행기로 괌에 갔습니다.
Of course, I took the ship inside of the Guam, right?
Inside. That's not true. What answer is number three?
Number 13.
친구가 오늘 이사를 했습니다. 제가 도와줘서 이사가 금방 끝났습니다. 새 집에서 친구와 저녁을 먹었습니다.
Main subject is my friend. And I. So what did I do, my friend?
이사,
moving the house.
And what did I do?
도와줘서, help my friend.
Okay. So, 오늘 is time vocabulary. 오늘 is today, right? So, my friend moved the house today. And I, 도와줘서, it will be the reason.
도와주다, 도와주어서.
I help him. That's why 이사가 금방 끝났습니다. The unpacked, you know, the unpacking. Unpacking finished very early. 금방, 금방 means very short time. 금방.
So I said, I would say water. I said water just right before, right? And in Korea,
방금 물이라고 말했습니다. Okay? 새 집에서 친구와 저녁을 먹었습니다. 새 집, 집 is house, 새 is new, for new house. New house에서 what did I do? 저녁을 먹었습니다. Eat dinner with whom? 친구와 함께. With my friend. Okay. Let's find which is not correct. It is correct. Okay. Number one. 제가 이사를 했습니다.
The person who moved the house is me?
No, my friend. B. Number two. 친구가 저를 도와주었습니다.
Who have the person who, you know, moved the house?
I have.
I didn't move the house. I helped my friend who moved the house today.
Number three, 지난주에, 지난주 means last week, right? Last week. 지난주 means last week. Last week. 지난주에, at the last week, my friend moved the house.
No, when does my friend move the house?
Owner, today. So not 지난주. Number four, 이사한 집에서 식사를 했습니다. 이사한 집, the house,
my friend move.
So 이사한 집 mean
새 집, new house, right? New house.
So number four will be the answer.
Let me see how many questions we have.
Oh, two more. Okay. Tomorrow, 14. 아침부터 비가 왔습니다. 저는 우산이 없어서 걱정을 했습니다. 그런데 동생이 우산을 가지고 학교 앞에서 기다리고 있었습니다.
Here's a keyword. Be.
Be, what is be? Rainy. Rain. It rained. So when? So we need to find out time vocabulary. 아침부터. 부터 means it's continuing. 아침부터 from this morning. 아침부터 from this morning 비가 왔습니다. It means it's still raining, right? It's still raining now. 저는 우산이 없어서. This will be the reason, right? I don't 우산이 없어서. 우산 mean umbrella. So, 없어요. Don't have. I don't have the umbrella. So, this is the reason. I don't have umbrella. So, 걱정을 했습니다. I'm 걱정을 하다. I'm worried. Right? I'm worried. 그런데, however,
okay, it changed something, right?
However, 그런데, however, 동생이
My brother. He's a hero, right?
My brother. 우산을 가지고 가지고 학교 앞에서 기다리고 있었습니다.
My brother has umbrella and he's
가지고 우산을 가지고 have an umbrella 학교 앞에서
in front of 학교 앞
in front of, right? In front of my school. So 앞에서 mean in front of. We can say that, right? 학교 앞에서 기다리고 있었습니다.
Waiting. My brother is waiting.
To whom? Me. So my brother is waiting for me in front of my school with umbrella.
How nice, right?
How nice. Let's find which is correct. Number one,
어제 비가 내렸습니다.
어제?
어제 rainy, yesterday?
아침부터 지금까지. From morning to now, 지금까지.
So it doesn't mean yesterday. Today, right? Today. I'm talking right now.
Number two, 저는 언니를 기다렸습니다. 언니 means sister, but there's nothing about the 언니, sister. 동생. little one, younger, right? Number three, 학교 앞에 동생이 있었습니다. 학교 앞에, in front of school, 앞에서 기다리고 있었어요. So 학교 앞에 동생이 있었습니다. There is my brother in front of my school with umbrella, right? Number four, 저는 학교에 우산을 가지고 왔습니다. Do I have umbrella? 저는 우산이 없어서 I don't have. So B, that's not correct. Number three will be the answer. Alright, we only have one more question. Number 15. 오늘 누나와 약속이 있었습니다. 그런데 버스를 잘못 타서 약속 장소에 늦게 도착했습니다. 누나는 화가 많이 났습니다. This is a story about 누나 and I. 누나 is older sister. Owner, time, vocabulary is owner. Today, today, 누나와 약속이 있었습니다. 약속 mean appointment. So we're going to, we have plan to meet. Right, plan. 오늘, today, today we have plan. You know. 그런데, however, something changed. So, very, very, I can guess something very bad happened, right? 그런데 버스를 잘못 타서 땡땡 아서 it will be the reason. So 그런데 버스를 잘못 타서 mean I took the wrong bus, right? I took the wrong bus, wrong number. 약속 장소에 늦게 도착했습니다. Late. Late. I late. 약속 장소에 늦게 도착했습니다. 누나는? Of course. Of course. 누나는 화가 많이 났습니다. 화, anger. 화가 많이 났습니다. In English, we can say my sister was very angry. Very easy, simple. But in Korea, 누나는 화가 많이 났습니다. Anger happened, okay? Number, so let's find out which is correct. Number one, 저는 누나를 못 만났습니다. Mean, I didn't meet my sister. But I was late, but I met my sister. How do I know? 누나는 화가 많이 났습니다. How do I know if I didn't meet my sister? If she is very angry or not, right? Number two, 저는 약속 시간에 늦었습니다. 늦었습니다. 약속 장소에 늦게 도착했습니다. 약속 장소에 늦게 도착 mean late for the time, right? 시간에 늦었습니다. 저는 3번, number 3, 저는 약속 장소를 몰랐습니다. I know where we meet, right? But I took the wrong bus, right? Number four, 저는 누나를 많이 기다렸습니다. 저는, 내가, I was waiting for my sister so long. It's not true. Who was waiting for so long? My sister. Sister was waiting for me so long. So that would be not answer. Right answer is number two. 약속 시간에 늦었습니다. 약속 장소에 늦게 도착했습니다. It's same meaning. Okay? Alright. That's all for today for type 4, the reading part of topic test. So next time we're going to study about type 5 of reading part of topic. Okay? So please come back again. Hopefully see you again and oops. Have a great day and 감사합니다. 다음 시간에 만나요.